In this lesson, we're going to focus on the client-side code. In particular, we're going to look at how the client has to send the username and the password to the revised Predictions 2 service so that Tomcat can perform the user's role's security. For convenience, I've put all of the files needed for this application in a zip. It's called auth.zip. And what you're looking at right now in my Emacs editor is predictions HTTPS client AA.java, cut down, of course, for readability. But the full version is included in a jar file. It's an executable jar file that I'll demo in a bit. So let me go through the important parts. This is a client, again, against the Predictions 2 service. We're going to use wire-level security, HTTPS, and we're also going to introduce, from the client side, users' roles security. So at line 1, you can see the URL as a string, HTTPS, and so forth. The name of the WAR file is Predictions 2AA, and that's included in the zip as well. Once again, we need the trust store because automatically the client is going to challenge Tomcat to send down its digital certificates. So that part is pretty much unchanged. Down at line 2, this is also unchanged code from the earlier HTTPS version. So this is basically the HTTPS setup all the way down here. And finally, at line 3, we get at the new parts. So we now need a username and a password. As you can see, I've hardwired the username and the password into the code for convenience, but we could, of course, read these in as command line arguments. What follows then in the full client code is the usual series of CRUD tests. So there's a get one test, a get all test, a post test, a put test, a delete test, and so on. So I've not shown the code for those. The important point for us is that each of these CRUD tests invokes this private method called getConnection. So this is where the action occurs for our purposes. So getConnection at line 4 expects 4 arguments. There's the URL, so that's the string converted into a Java URL instance. There's the verb, get, post, put, delete, and the username and the password, in this case, hardwired, as shown above. We now jump into a try block and open up an HTTPS URL connection. We've seen that before. We set it for both input and output. We're going to be sending data over to the service. We're going to be getting data back from the service. So we need both of those. And then the request method is set. So the get, post, put, delete, and so forth. Now we get to the point of interest for us. So let me just do a tiny bit of background here. Basically, Tomcat implements the HTTP 1.1 spec when it comes to so-called basic user authentication. What that means, in effect, is that it wants the username and the password configured in a very precise way. We've seen this sort of thing before in writing clients, for example, against Amazon. So the same thing occurs here, although we're following, in effect, a standard. The first thing is this. We create a string, I just call it user pass here, and it's the concatenation of the username and the password with the two separated by a colon, no white space. So in this case, it's mo, colon, mo, mo, mo. And the last three mos, of course, are capitalized. Now, there are two further steps. Next, we create another string called basic, followed by a single blank, followed by basically the base 64 encoding of this username password concatenation. So this, in effect, is required by the standard. So this is the fussy part, if you like, at line 6. Finally, at line 7, the URL connection class has very convenient properties. I'm using one of those right here. Con set request property. This basically is going to create an HTTP header element. The key for that element is going to be authorization, even though technically what we're doing is user authentication. So it's authorization, and then this base 64 encoded combination of the username and the password. With those changes, we're now good to go. So let me demo this from the command line. So as you can see, I have an executable jar. It's called predictions https client aa.jar. It's included in that zip file. I'm going to run it and hope for the best. We get some XML output. This is the output from the standard series of CRUD tests that you've seen any number of times.